Hi! The beautiful phone swipe animation you will learn to create today looks like this. On a click, we talk about the first photo shown on the phone. Then on a click, a hand comes and swipes the photo to reveal the second photo and the details of that photo are shown. Then on a click, the hand comes, swipes the photo to reveal the next one and the details of that photo is shown here. You can use this beautiful PowerPoint animation effect to showcase different photos and provide details about them. Instead of photos, if you want to use the space to showcase different titles and provide the description on this side, you can do so as well. The uses of this beautiful animation is limited only by your imagination. In this video, I'll show you how to create this awesome looking animation from scratch. By the way, I'm Ramgopal from presentationprocess.com. We share creative PowerPoint ideas to help professionals like you create engaging presentations. The first step is to get some basic assets we need. For that, I'm going to use pixabay.com. Here, when you search for phone mockup, you'd be able to get this photo. I downloaded this image and cropped out this portion only to retain the portion on the left that you can see here. The next image of the hand is picked up from another public domain photo taken from pixabay.com, and this is the hand I'm talking about. I downloaded the picture and then used transparent color option by going to picture format, color and use set transparent color option, and then I clicked on the white area so I'm able to remove that white and have this image as an isolated one. So we have the phone and the hand available to us, and this is going to be the base for us to create this animation. The first step is to go to this slide which has the phone mockup. Let me draw a rectangle that covers this white space by using this auto shape gallery, and let us punch a hole in this image by selecting the image first. Hold the shift button down and then select this rectangle that we just drew. And then let us go to shape format, go to merge shapes and say shape subtract. Now we have a hole in this image in the area where you see as white. You would be able to see this much better if I were to change the format background to some other color, like say the steel color, and you can see that this is a transparent area. Now while we change the format color, you could also see that this portion here is also a transparent one. We don't really want it. We want it to have the same color as this color here. So here it is white. So I'm going to have a rectangle drawn here. So we are able to have this area totally blocked with white color. So let me right click and duplicate this slide so we are able to retain the original one in the first slide. Let us go to the second slide and then go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the rectangle tool and draw a rectangle that covers the slide end to end like this. Then go to Shape Fill, go to the white color here, go to Shape Outline and say no outline. Now let us select this rectangle, hold the shift button down and select this image, right click, cut it, and then right click and this time paste it back as a picture. Now what you see here is a mask with a picture on one side and an opaque rectangle on the other side with a hole here which we are going to use to fill with an image and use the swiping motion. Now let us go to the previous slide and draw a rectangle once again to cover this entire teal area and then use that as a measure or a placeholder to have three pictures cropped in the same dimension. So let me go to Auto Shapes Gallery, pick up the rectangle tool and then draw a rectangle like so. Let me right click on this, cut this, go to a new slide and then place this over here, and you can hold the shift button down, click and drag from the corner so you can use this as a model to have the various pictures inserted and cropped to the right shape. The way you do that is you duplicate this shape, give it a clear outline so you can see the shape, and then remove the fill and then put a picture behind, and using this as the guidance you can crop the image to its shape, and the result is this. It's a fairly simple thing to do. I don't want to waste your time showing you how to do this. So we've got these images which I'm going to place on this space here so we are able to create our animation. Now the next step is to pick up this image by pressing Ctrl X and then go here and paste it in the slot that we have created for it. Let us hold the shift button down and ensure that the size of this matches with the size of the placeholder. The next step is to go once again to this page here and then pick up this image by pressing Ctrl X and pressing Ctrl V to place this and stack this right on top of the previous one. Let us hold the shift button down and do the adjustment. Now this image is placed. The next step is to go to this slide where we have this isolated image of the hand which we downloaded earlier. Let us cut this and then come back to this slide and press Ctrl V, and then let us zoom out so that we are able to place this in such a way that it looks like we are going to use this to swipe to remove this image from the scene. So we place this to align with somewhere in the bottom area of this photo. Now let us go back to the original slide size, and when you see here, this is how the image looks. Now instead of this hand being in the scene, I'm going to have this enter the scene with a simple animation. Let us select this, go to animations, open the animation pane so you can follow what I'm going to do. This hand needs to enter with a simple floating animation like so, and this need not be for 1 second, which is the duration. Let us have this reduced to 0.5 seconds duration. Now we have the hand entering the scene. Let us go back to the main focus here. Then I'm going to apply a simple animation that moves this image out of the scene. So let us select this image, then go to the option for motion paths and select this line motion path. By default, the direction is down. Let us move this right, and this has moved out of the scene. It doesn't have to go that far off. Let me click on this red button and then have it move somewhere towards the edge like this. Now the next step is to apply the same motion path animation to take this hand from here to here, giving it the illusion that this hand is swiping this picture of the scene. So let us select this. Since we already have an animation on this, which is a floating animation, we need to add another animation, which is motion path animation. And by default, the direction is down, as I said earlier. Let us go to right, and we need to end this exactly where this photo ends. So let us select this. And here you see the endpoint. Let us hold the shift button down and move it in such a way that it corresponds with the edge of the photo here. And then ensure that the duration of both of these is only 0.5 seconds. And the order of animation is the second one, which is the picture moving happens after previous, and along with that, the hand moves, so it is with previous. So the animation so far is the hand comes in and this picture and the hand move to one side so that the picture is slid off. Now we need to take the hand off the scene. So let us select this hand, add animation, and then apply a simple float out animation so it leaves the scene, and this happens after previous and this happens for 0.5 seconds. Now when I go to slideshow, on a click, you can see the hand comes and swipes it off the scene, revealing the picture behind. But then this image still is visible and it looks ugly. So we need to use the mask that we created earlier. When you go here to the previous slide, you remember we created this mask with this rectangle. Let us cut this by right clicking and using the cut option, and then go back here and paste on top of this. Now you don't really see the background. And when the image slides off, you will not be able to see because this mask, which is a hole here, is able to mask out all the unnecessary details. So when I go to slideshow, the hand comes and swipes the image, and the image is not visible, but then the hand is not visible either. So let me go to this hand image and then right click and bring to front. Now when I go to slideshow, you can see the hand comes and slides this off, and you're able to reveal the image at the back. Now, all you need to do is to add some text that gives details of the image that is shown here. And it is very simple. You just use the text box tool to write this and have this enter the scene with a simple fade in animation. You can go to animations and use the fade animation. And this happens after previous. So when we go to slideshow, a hand comes and removes one image, revealing the details of the image underneath. In the example that I showed you, I did exactly the same thing with three images stacked one on top of the other, and I've given here the names of each of these images so it is easy for your reference. Let me zoom in so you're able to see the various animations. It is the same set of animations that are shown over and over again to create this beautiful hand swipe animation on a phone. If you really see, we didn't really use anything fancy. All we used is a simple motion path animation and a fade animation. But then the way we used these animations created this beautiful scene. So it is not the tools, but the way you use the tools with creativity that creates magic in PowerPoint. If you want to learn the PowerPoint animation skills to create the same kind of magic in your presentations, all you need to do is to click on the link here and start following this short playlist of videos that we have put together on PowerPoint custom animation. All you need to do is to click on the link here and start watching the videos and improve your PowerPoint animation skills right now.